you know, it's kind of hard sometimes to find clean water in this world, and sometimes you can't see the bottom of the river or it's polluted. This one out here, it's very nice because you can go either to the Jack's Fork or the current and look all the way to the bottom and see it. It's crystal clean, and it's a very, very nice river system, and that's why it is a national park on the same level as Yosemite or Yellowstone or any other national park. Starting in 1868, people started coming to this region out here at Alley. The mill itself was built in 1894. And as the mill got built 100 years ago, you couldn't buy a sack of flour, you couldn't buy a loaf of bread as we do today. It wasn't available. And being an Ozark farmer, you didn't have money to go and spend on this bread or flour if it was available, which it wasn't. So you would have had to utilize a mill such as this one to have your grain ground down into a product that you could use, such as flour or cornmeal. So the mill was very important for people back then. It provided that source of life. They used to call bread the staple of life, and there would be a loaf of bread on Ozark's tables, whether it be breakfast, lunch, or dinner, and you could slice you off a piece and have that with your meal, so it was very important. But 100 years ago, people would have brought their grain to Alley. They would have dropped it off here for the miller to grind down, and they would have waited for that. You would stay in the Alley community, and they used to call that milling around, and they would mill around. For you kids, that means you're hanging out or wasting time, something like that. They would mill around. They would go to the mercantile store, get supplies. It was a time for people to socialize. You got to remember, this was a time without telephones and emails. So when they came together, it was a time for neighbors to catch up on old times and talk about the year past and everything. Of course, the water is our power. That's why the mill is here. When I go over here and I turn this wheel, what I'm doing is opening up those flaps, allowing the water to drain out and kick the machines in motion. So. There you go, 112 years later, of course, still running, still operating. It was very important, these roller mills, because without them you wouldn't have had your daily bread. So you're all welcome to go mill around as they used to.